Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. I recently received a new Dwarf II telescope, a new improved version. My old one started to have some problems with the base, more specific the charger, it didn't charge very well. And I understand other units had base problems. They sent me a replacement unit with stronger base, and also they fixed the charger issues that I had with my model. And now if you'll order the Dwarf II, you'll be able to get the new improved version. We'll also test out the new firmware version that comes with binning 1x1 in astrophotography mode and with solar and lunar live stacking. Now let's begin the test. We'll mount the new Dwarf II on a larger tripod and we'll place the solar filters. We'll activate Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and we will connect to the dwarflab app. First we'll point the telescope in the direction of the sun, having the filters on the lenses. We will use the secondary lens to find and center the sun using the virtual joystick to move up, left and right. First let's select the settings we want. We'll go also at white balance and select the white balance for the sun called sunlight. After this we'll select the exposure time, 1/200 of a second, and gain 0. Now we are almost ready. Now we need to focus and we'll press the autofocus. And fortunately we have at the moment some clouds, and I will use now the manual focus to be able to achieve focus because of the clouds. If not, the autofocus should work fine. We will wait now until these clouds will pass and test the live stacking feature for the sun. Now the clouds passed and we'll begin testing the new live stacking feature. We'll go back on astrophotography mode. Make sure you have binning off. This is how it looks the setting in firmware 1.8. It will change in the next versions of the app. So make sure you check also the future videos. On count, you can leave the default number and stop it after you have 5 to 10 images stacked, or select a lower number, like in this case, 300. Format, I recommend you to leave fits. Let's begin and start the live stacking. And Dwarf II will capture the sun and will stack the images. Just after seeing a couple of images, we can see a lot of details here on the sun's surface. We can see the dust spots. I'm very impressed with how the image looks here on directly on the screen. In this update, we can still play with the tone curves and make some adjustments. It's important to note that it is already looking good directly from the image app, even if you won't do any processing. I will show you first how you can improve even further the image taken with the sun. Adjust it a little bit more, the white balance, the background, and here the saturation and a little bit more sharpening. So look at these details, right? We can see very nice the sunspots, and we can see texture here on the sun's surface. Very, very nice. This makes me recommend the deluxe version of the Dwarf II because it has the filter holder and also the two ND filters. So you can just place here the filter holder with the two solar ND filters and make fast a live capture of the sun. Here we have the ND filters. So without these filters, you cannot capture the sun with the Dwarf II because it can damage the telescope. So do not point the Dwarf II at the sun without any special filters, like these two ND filters that will protect the Dwarf II scope. Now let's continue and go to the lunar live stacking test. So we have the moon rising now and we'll begin testing the new stacking feature. This feature is made using the astrophotography mode with binning off, and we'll be able to use it also for deep sky. So we'll get directly 4K image text and image files. First we'll test it on the moon, and then I will test it on Orion, Nebula and Andromeda galaxy. Now let's begin with the moon stacking. After I connected the Dwarf II, I simply moved the telescope and pointed towards the moon. And after that, I also moved first the optical tube so we can see the moon through the wide field lens here on the left. To center it, we can use the joystick here on the left part of the screen. In this firmware version, I've tested the lunar tracking mode in daytime is at the moment not available, so I needed to go to the Astro mode to be able to track the moon. So I selected auto go to, selected moon, and it also tried to place solve that it failed. I reported these issues to Dwarf Lab and discussed about it, and in the future public update, they will make available also daytime lunar tracking, and we will avoid these problems that I had here. After we got the tracking on and we recentered the moon, I had also to get the settings back. And I've selected shutter speed 1/200 of a second, gain 0. After this, we can go in live staking and make sure that we have 4K resolution. In this version of the app, we can see binning off for 2x2. In the future update that I've tested and will show you soon, 2.0, we have already default binning 1x1. We will start the lunar live staking. In just a few seconds, we already have here a live stack of the moon with amazing details. The white balance in this version of the app is a little bit off, but I think Dwarf Lab will fix that really soon because they are already working on the firmware 2.1. Now let's see also a longer stack. I left it about 10 minutes. When I came back, I found a stack of 42 images from 500. So we have the moon just after the first quarter with an illumination of 60-65%, captured here with the Dwarf II Smart Telescope. And look, we can see Copernicus crater in very nice details just near the terminator. Tostenes, here we can see Plato crater. So we can see also the craters Tycho, Maginus and Clavius here on the lower part of the image. After testing the new Dwarf II telescope, the new unit with the new live staking features also on the moon, I was again impressed with the results. Both lunar and solar did work very good. I was able just in a few seconds to get a short stack with the moon in great details, with good quality and amazing details, especially in the highlights. I still believe that Dwarf Lab will improve this and hopefully we will get a better white balance directly in depth without making any adjustments. But I'm very pleased so far with the results testing these features in the firmware upgrade 1.8. Regarding deep sky astrophotography, with the new binning 1x1 feature, I will be brief in this video because we have new updates that will give us even more features that I do want to share in more details later. So the biggest change regarding deep sky astrophotography is the live staking in 4K resolution. The same used also for solar and lunar, it will work also for the deep sky. So what's the difference here? We had a binning 2x2 available. That means we had a full HD image that had also larger pixels and less details on the deep sky objects that we captured. So having larger pixels with a smaller focal length of 100 millimeters gave us about 6 arc seconds per pixel. And now with the 4K resolution, we will have like 3 arc seconds per pixel. That is a big improvement and will allow us to get better details on our astrophotography images. More about this in future videos, but I want to show you first some of the tests that I made on Orion Nebula and Running Man Nebula. We can get them both in the same field of view and we'll be able to get better resolution now. Also, Andromeda Galaxy, having this option now will allow us to get more details visible than before. Brief, I want to tell you that the new update that I've recently tested, the 2.0, has a new autofocus feature on Infiniti that helps you get directly a good focus on stars. It's a big upgrade considering that we had to do manual focus all the time until now. Also, we have available a new star catalog with much more deep sky objects. And I also heard that Dwarf Lab is working to integrate in the app Sky Atlas that will allow you to use the go-to feature to point everywhere in the night sky. With the new improved Dwarf 2 unit, and with the new firmware updates, we do have now a better Dwarf 2 than we did before. Before we finish the video, I want to let you know that I have shared affiliate links with the Dwarf 2 telescope that will give you the best price possible directly on the dwarflab website. Also, fantastic discounts on Black Friday. I believe the Dwarf 2 will be 20% off. So it is a great time to buy the Dwarf 2 if you are interested in this telescope. Also, if you have any questions about the Dwarf 2 telescope, just write them in the comments below. We'll share also on the channel membership image results with the Dwarf 2 telescope from the reviews. Don't forget to check also the membership out, so you'll be able to download the data. Zoom in and check in more details the images and captures with the Dwarf 2 smart telescope. Until next time on Galaxy Media, wish you all clear sky.